What's going on, everybody? David Lyle with PopWood Woodworking. The shop is almost clean, and I'm really happy about it. We just knocked out this build earlier this week. It's walnut slash bacon. It looks like bacon if you look at it from the top. But it's a live edge waterfall coffee table with just a single leg up front. We did this build with a circular saw and some really simple tools. So I'm really excited about this. This was the one that we were talking about a few weeks ago in partnership with Horizon Slabs or Horizon Wood Products. They sell slabs, pretty cool service. So I'm excited about that. Also this week, we got a bunch of boxes from Rockler. They have, if you've been around their store lately, they've been pushing their bench dog hand planes again. They've kind of relaunched them to some degree. And so I was just taking these out, giving them a look. The number 7 is out. One thing that I thought was kind of neat is they have this inspection report. And so they give you the tolerances and what their observation was, including blade hardness and the flatness here, and then it's signed by their inspector, which I thought was a nice touch. So I haven't put it on wood yet. I don't know how it works. I don't know if it's a good tool or not, yet. But I'll be digging into that in the next week or two. I still haven't reviewed that bandsaw. I told you I was gonna be reviewing soon. So I think that, then these, for the June issue of the magazine. With that, sorry, I'm feeling a little under the weather today, so my nose is not working. But I wanna jump into this first video from Michael Alm. He built a record player cabinet, and the top and I think bottom of it were a product called cover ply. He said they were offcuts from a friend's kitchen. It's Baltic birch, I think a couple layers, and then it has a layer of this paper stone product, which is like a recycled, probably sort of resin-based, sustainable product that basically makes for a pretty indestructible surface. So he uses that leftover material and then a bunch of other stuff to make this really beautiful record player cabinet, so check that out. Next up is Jason's video from Bent Woodworking. Yeah, Bent's Woodworking. This is a great video because he explains his assembly table. And so this is not necessarily a build video, but more of his ideas that went into the assembly table he built, which is equally productive because, you know, sometimes if you've been woodworking long enough, you don't need to be shown how to build something, but you need the insight about a product before you build it. And so Jason really walks through all the decisions that he made on this assembly table, everything from the height to the size of it, to the way that the storage works, that kind of thing. So he has some really good thoughts, and they are the product of his experience. This is not philosophy. This is like what has worked for him, which is really insightful, you know, if you're getting started and you need some good advice. So check this out. Next up is from our future sponsor, Nissan Automobiles. No, they're not a sponsor. But they have an NV300 concept van that they, I don't know if it was actually at the Brussels Motor Show. But anyway, they put out this video about a concept van that's basically a woodworking van, like portable workstation. And they are kind of talking about this power pack, this battery pack that they have, that they claim can run some high powered tools in it. It's a really beautifully shot video. The van is a work of art. They put a lot of effort into this. So this is not necessarily like a woodworking video by a YouTuber, but I thought it was really interesting. And it came up when I was looking at some of the newer woodworking videos on YouTube. So I hope you find it interesting too. Check it out. Next up is Chad Stanton, who is a friend of Popular Woodworking. He did a beginner's woodworking bench over on his channel, sponsored by Woodcraft. It's a really good build. He talks about, again, this is kind of like Jason's video, where he talks about why he made the design decisions that he did on this build, but he also does the whole build video for you as well. And One of the cool things is that he's offering free plans when you sign up for his newsletter for this build. And so he builds one that's kind of inexpensive and smaller. And then at the end of the video, if you stick around for the whole thing, he does another one that's a little more complicated, but it's a knockdown. So you can take it apart and store it away, but it does some half-blind dovetailed ends and stuff. Anyway, it's a really good build and I like the paint job on it and you should check it out. Oh, speaking of Chad, that reminds me, he does have a newer book with us. I'm not trying to sneak that in. I just forgot until just now. I promise. Anyway, it's 20 projects from the I Can Do That series, which he did with us for a few years in video. They're on paper now, and you can get that book over on the site. And I think the ebook is on sale right now. It's like $16.99 or something. It's a great deal. So I'm going to link to that in the description if you're interested in some easy woodworking projects. And with that, I need to go because I'm not feeling well. And it's Friday. So we will see you next week. If you're interested in getting your woodworking video on PopWood Playback, please send me an email. I'll have that in the description of this video as well. And thank you for all of your kind words last week. We'll see you.